PowerDirector green screen or PowerDirector chroma key. I'm going to teach you in this tutorial how to work with a green screen and give you some tips. So make sure you watch this video to the end where you get everything so you fully understand everything I do with a green screen. And I'm going to take you through it step by step here in PowerDirector so it helps you to understand how to green screen. And anybody can do it. Now, the first thing I do is grab this video that's on green screen that I took earlier this week, and I'll pull that down. The image I want to use is this particular one with an office building with beautiful, beautiful windows. And once I get all that lined up in PowerDirector and I'm stretching the image out, okay, so we're good to go there. Now, in PowerDirector, we have a couple options we can do here when we work in a chroma key or a green screen. I can click up here. Make sure you click on the video that has the green screen. And then click on Designer. And now I have two ways I can go here. I can go into Mask Designer, or I can go to PIP Designer, which is Picture-in-Picture Designer. If I go into Mask Designer is what I would do first, then I'm actually going to select a rectangle. It's probably the shape that most people will end up selecting for most of their green screening. So look at that. Now, if I don't want this box and the cellophane and everything inside this video, I could simply move this over like so. So now I got that out of the way. Now you're going to want to make sure here on the left where it says maintain aspect ratio, check that off. So that way you can really get pretty detailed with your box here. Now I could move this over a little bit. I could move this up and cut all that out a little bit. I could even move this down, and now I'm looking pretty good there. So now I'm going to say okay, and there's how I'm looking right now. Now remember, I did that in Mask Designer, which is that one there. But I really don't want myself there. I'm going to bring myself down. And maybe a little bit more. Line myself up like that. Okay. Now I'm going to go back. And this time we're going to go into Picture on Picture Designer. Last time we did the Mask Designer. We're going to do the PIP Designer this time. And now I'm going to click Chroma Key on the left. Click my eyedropper. And I try to get as close as I can to my hair. And then I click, and that lined it up pretty good. But if we actually play that through, you're going to see how it's gradiented there a little bit. And I hope you can see that. You also see where my hand kind of went off the screen a little bit. So I'm going to stop that. And the reason for that is because these numbers here on the left are not perfect. Now, I normally know what to do with my numbers because I work my green screen all the time. But normally I just add 5 to everything is what I do. And I can get it pretty close by doing that. And you'll notice I ran my edge sharpness to 3. A lot of people have cranked that up to 6, but I find I don't have to do that. So now I'll hit play. Got a tiny bit in there, not too much. And the shirt's not perfectly good. So as you can see, you're going to end up playing with your numbers a little bit and finding what makes sense to you and what looks good to you on your eyes. And it's just a matter of playing with these numbers until you get what you like. Move it up, move it down, change them. And the more tighter you get it, the better. And if you get stuck or whatever, hit your reset button and everything will go back to what it was originally. So you can actually start over if you want. And then maybe that will help you just begin where you left off, basically. And you'll see when the numbers aren't really right, what happens, see how my hair is going through my head? Look up here, it's black. See that? So everything it's black is trying to find. Because when I hit reset, I didn't hit the eyedropper and then come over and select the green screen. And now we got it. So that's not too bad. Now let me give you some tips with green screening to fully understand, and I'll let this play out so you guys can see this as it goes. Green screening is very important with lighting. Okay, if you can get a light to the left and a light to the right, you want to remove any shadows off the green screen. So you don't want to put your back right up against the green screen. You literally want to move like a good 2 to 3 to 4 feet in front of the green screen. And this way it removes shadows. This is very important when you chroma key, because if you have any shadows on your green screen at all, it's actually going to harm you when you chroma key. It's going to make it, well, it's not going to harm you. It's going to make it more difficult is what it's going to do, I should say, is what's going to happen. I'm trying to find one, if I can, where I got a little bit of shadow off to the right. Because I move around quite a bit with my body. And I am about 2 feet, maybe about 2.5 feet away from the green screen when I'm doing this. And I do have two big lights that shoot from either side onto the green screen to remove any shadows behind me. If you can put a green screen in the back of the green screen, that even helps too. So we're trying to get that solid color, but with no shadows and nothing different on the green screen. Another thing I've noticed when working with green screens, if you move less. So if I'm literally talking in front of the green screen and not moving as much as I am, it actually makes it a lot easier to chroma key it, is what it does. So those are tips if you want to get it as perfect as you can, basically. So I'm going to go here, and this one I'm not even going to do the mask designer. I'm only going to do the picture-in-picture designer is what I'm going to do. And we'll chroma key this. Give me the eyedropper. Okay. I'm going to take this, beef it up to 3. That's normally what I do. Give me a 20 on this one. Up 5. Up 5. And I'll go up 10 on that one. And then just hit OK. So there we go. Now I'm talking in this room. Now I imagine I could shrink this down to make it a little bit more realistic, because I seem to be a lot bigger than the room. So maybe bring it down so I'm not as big. And maybe it'll look just a little bit better. No, I'm probably too small. But to get the general idea, when you're working with the green screen with PowerDirector or a chroma key, and trying to make it look as nice as you can. And you can really get pretty crazy with green screen inside a green screen is what you can do. Now, I've also got a tutorial on how I make my backgrounds with a green screen. I mean, the end of my video, where I've got like a video and a green screen. I'll give you a card to that, and you can go check out that video, because that's actually quite interesting what I do there. But here's a great tutorial, guys, for PowerDirector on how to work with your green screen. Oh, by the way, a green screen doesn't have to be green. Okay, a green screen can be black, it can be yellow, it can be white, whatever color you want if you've got a blank wall. Just keep in mind when you put color on color what's going on. For example, my hair is brown, so if my background was brown and I was using that as my green screen, that color, I would literally wipe out my head. If it was black, then I would end up wiping out my microphone, is what would happen. So it's very, very important, whatever you decide what color to use for a green screen, because some screens are blue and you have a blue screen, that it doesn't clash with what the person's wearing. So you really want to make sure that whatever you're wearing is not the same color in the background. Like, for example, I wonder if I could show you. Let me go here. And I'm going to go to Mask Designer, and I'm going to open this right up. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go back up to here. And stretch this out. Now, what I'm going to show you here is... Okay, I got this stretched out. I got a black watch on. You see that there? So I'm going to go back into my designer, and I'm going to go into my picture-in-picture designer. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the color of my watch. So let's say I had a black background. Look just what happened. See that? I just took out my hair, and I just took out my watch. My eyes changed. There's no way I'm going to fix that. So if I had a black background or if I had a brown background, there is no way I'm going to be able to basically do a green screen with PowerDirector. So this is the reason why they use a green or a blue, because most of those colors don't clash with anything. But if a person was wearing all white and they're a white person and they're standing in front of a black wall, they would be completely fine. Or if you really want to get fancy, let's say you're standing in front of a black wall and you wear black clothes and a black hood and everything. You could literally disappear on the screen now. So you could literally be holding something in your hand and it could be flying and moving around like a puppet or whatever, and they're not even going to see you. So you can do a lot of special effects with green screening, and you can get pretty crazy. It's only with whatever imagination you've got on how you're going to do your green screen with PowerDirector. I do have a tutorial, another one there, guys. I'll have a link at the top there you can click on in the card section. But here's a quick rundown. Just keep in mind when you're clicking on your green screen, you're working within this designer button here, and it's within this section of working with your green screen with PowerDirector. And I'll catch you guys on the next one. If you have enjoyed this video on how to actually use a green screen in PowerDirector, you might want to subscribe below so that way you don't miss any other tutorials. And you may also want to watch the other video that's inside the box of this video. At any rate, guys, I'll catch you guys on the next one. And yes, this was also used with a green screen.